In this example, once again, I don't have any values. I only know that I have a point load in the mid-span of a simply supported beam. Of course, this is point A, this can be point B and point C. So practically the height or the depth, if you want, of the beam is virtually zero. The first step, as always, would be to draw the support reactions. Here you can see the support reactions drawn, even calculated, but of course we will be calculating them ourselves anyway. So these red ones are the support reactions at these points. This would be RAY, this would be RAX, and this would be RCY. So if I apply the equations of equilibrium, I can calculate the support reactions. Typically, I start with the sum of moments when I have any other structure except for cantilever beams, because this is the easiest way to directly calculate one unknown variable, one support reaction in this case. So the sum of moments about any point has to be equal to zero. I can take the sum of moments either about point A or about point C. I will select point A so that I can calculate RCY. Now, here it is up to me to select the positive direction. I will assume that the moments which are counterclockwise are positive. So, W times L over 2. And of course, because it is a clockwise moment, it will be a negative one. So, minus W L over 2 plus R C Y times L, because it is a clockwise moment, equals 0. So if I solve for R C Y, I just move this part of the equation to the right side, and then I divide by L, so RCY equals W over 2. Which is what you saw in the sketch over here, but of course now we have shown how to calculate that. Now I can apply the sum of forces in Y direction, which has to be equal to 0, and calculate RAY in this case. Let's assume that the ones pointing upwards are positive, so RAY minus W plus, I already know RCY, so I will substitute as it is, plus W over 2 equals 0. So if I solve for RAY, here it is negative W over 2, so if I move it to the right side it becomes positive, so this is RAY, W over 2, as you can see in the sketch as well. Finally, I go to the sum of forces in X direction, which has to be equal to 0. The ones pointing to the right are the positive ones in my case. So RAX has to be equal to 0 because there is no other force on my sketch. Horizontal force, of course. So now that I have calculated the support reactions, all I need to do is to perform sections near the points of interest. Here I have one point of interest at A, so I need to perform a section a bit to the right from A. There is nothing a bit to the left from A. Also, I need to perform a section a bit to the left from C, because once again there is nothing to the right from C. And these are points of interest because they are the left and right end of the beam. And we also have two points of interest, one over here and one over here, a bit to the left and a bit to the right from B, because I have a point load. so I need to perform four sections. Let's start with the first one, section a bit to the right from A. I will draw the free body diagram for the section. I will keep the left part, so the horizontal force is zero, there's no need to draw it over here. The vertical force at point A is already calculated, so I just draw it like that, W over 2. And I also draw the internal forces at point A. MA, NA, and SA. So, applying the equations of equilibrium, I can calculate all of them in any order. So, let me start with the sum of forces in x direction, which has to be equal to 0. I'll get the ones pointing to the right as positive, because NA points to the right, so NA has to be equal to 0. The sum of forces in y direction has to be equal to 0. I'll get as positive the forces that point downwards, because SA points downwards. So SA minus W over 2 equals 0, or SA equals W over 2. Finally, the sum of moments about point A has to be equal to 0. I will assume that the counterclockwise moments are positive because MA is a counterclockwise moment and because there is no distance between the forces and point A, this is the only moment, so MA has to be equal to 0. Now we will perform a section a bit to the left from point B. So, if I draw the free body diagram for this section, having kept the left part and removed the right part, it will look like that. Of course, do not forget to draw the internal forces. And here, I need to point out also that because it is a bit left from point B, it is over here, force W has not yet applied at B. So, this is NB left, this is SB left, and this is MB left. So, if I take the sum of forces in x direction, which has to be equal to 0, and the ones pointing to the right are the positive ones, NB left has to be equal to 0 because there is no other horizontal force over there. Now I can take the sum of forces in y direction, which also has to be equal to 0. The ones pointing downwards are the positive ones. So SBL minus W over 2 has to be equal to 0, or SBL has to be equal to W over 2. Finally, the sum of moments about any point now, because I know the other two variables, but typically I would take it about the point of the section, so about point B in this case, has to be equal to 0. So if the counterclockwise moments are 0, MBL, of course SBL and NBL have a 0 moment. However, I do have the W over 2, which creates a moment about point B. It is a clockwise moment, so it's a negative 1 minus w over 2 times the distance, which is L over 2 equals 0. So if I solve for mbl, this is wl over 4. Now I can perform a section a bit to the right from B. So before I even start working this out, let's see what has changed from the previous section. So the only additional component in my free body diagram will be this load, load W. This means that the only thing that should change, because W doesn't really have any additional distance or nothing changes over here, so the only thing that should change is the shear force at the right of B. Let's check this out. This is W, the section now is over here. This is W over 2. The distance between these ends is still L over 2. And now I have NBR, SBR, and MBR. So if I take the sum of forces in x direction, which has to be equal to 0, the ones pointing to the right are the positive ones, so nbr has to be equal to 0. The sum of forces in y direction also has to be equal to 0, the ones pointing downwards are positive, so sbr minus w over 2 plus w equals 0, or sbr equals, now if I move all of this to the right side and solve for sbr, this is minus w over 2, it's a negative 1. And of course the sum of moments about any point, but once again it will be about point B, has to be equal to 0. The counterclockwise moments will be the positive ones, so MBR minus W over 2 times L over 2 has to be equal to 0, or MBR must be WL over 4. So what you can see over here is that, as I mentioned earlier, what we expected is a change in the shear forces only. And this is what we can notice. The shear forces now became negative. It's not just a change in the sign, it is actually a change with a magnitude equal to the force that applies over there. Of course, I have the last section. Section a bit to the left from C. I have done this one, this one, this one, so this is the last section. I can see over here that I could keep the left part and remove the right one, but it's much easier if I keep the right part. It's much, much smaller, and I remove the left part, so the internal forces will be like that, NC, SC, and MC. And don't forget the support reaction, which I calculated earlier, and it is W over 2. Of course, this is point C. So, if I take the sum of forces in x direction, which has to be equal to 0, and I assume that the ones pointing to the left are positive, I only have nc, which must be 0. The sum of forces in y direction also has to be equal to 0 if the ones pointing upwards are positive. Sc plus w over 2 has to be equal to 0, or Sc has to be negative w over 2. And the sum of moments about point C also has to be equal to 0. Since my unknown moment is clockwise, I will select this direction as the positive one. So MC has to be equal to 0 because, once again, there is no distance between the forces that I see in my free body diagram and point C. So only the moment applies over there. At this point, I have calculated all internal forces, so I am ready to draw the internal forces diagrams. Here I will be drawing the moments. Here will be the shears. And let's say here will be the axial forces. Once again, M, S, N. Now, because I do not have any values, there is no need to add any units because I don't know the units that would be used. So, for the moments, I know that the moment at point A is 0, the moment at point B is WL over 4, it is a positive one, so I draw it, and the moment at point C is also 0. I have point loads, I just connect all points with straight lines. This is plus, this is WL over 4, and this is my bending moment diagram. Similarly for the shear forces, but now the positive ones are above the axis, or above the beam, as this axis represents. At point A, I have a positive W over 2. A bit left from B, it is still W over 2, so it will look like that. A bit to the right from B, it is negative W over 2, so minus W over 2. And a bit to the left from C, it is still negative W over 2. And once again, because I only have point loads, the same would apply for the shears if I had a rectangular uniformly distributed load, I can connect all points with straight lines as I already did. So I also show that one part is positive, one part is negative, and this will be the shear forces diagram. Now for the axial forces, at all points of interest, they are zero. I don't see any point load or any uniformly distributed load between these points of interest, so it is safe to assume that the whole diagram is zero, and this is how I show a zero internal force diagram.